we had a sneak here, or sneak listen, yeah, of trespassing. We were very blown away.
Thank you.
So we've got lots of questions for you today. So you talk about trespassing being kind of a culmination of the last couple years of your life. How is it different from when you, first put out your first CD?
I've learned a lot about myself, and I've learned a lot about myself personally and as an artist, and I've also learned a lot about the industry and my fans. I mean, I think when I first made album number one, water delivery.
Thank you.
Water. When I made For Your Entertainment, I think it was kind of a guessing game.
Yeah.
And I'm proud of the album. I think it turned out great, but it was, I just come off of Idol, and I was doing a stadium tour, and I recorded the album in like a month and a half. So it's like very like kind of just thrown together, and, yeah, and there's great songs on it. But with this album, I was able to take what I had learned about promoting an album, touring an album, what my fans liked, what they didn't like, what I liked doing, the music video process, the whole thing.
Yeah.
And I had that in the back of my head when I made this album. I knew what I was getting into. And also I had time with this album. I had time, and I co-wrote most of the tracks. I executive produced the album. So
creative direct even.
Yeah, I'm doing all the creative direction. Yeah. I'm working one-on-one with the art director, with my photographer for the packaging. I styled myself for the cover. I mean, like, I'm not saying it to brag. Mm-hmm. I just really wanted to just do it myself.
Yeah.
You know, I don't need a bunch of people blowing smoke and helping, and yeah, I think the label has been amazing. My management's been amazing. I definitely wouldn't be able to do it alone. They facilitated everything, and their expertise and their taste and some of their suggestions have been integral. But it's definitely like, this is my baby. This is my vision, totally realized with time and focus. Yeah.
Fantastic.
Yeah, I'm so excited.
We're excited too. Now, we heard Cuckoo, and I have to say, so far, I haven't heard. Yeah, we're totally
really
obsessed.
And it's not even mixed yet. I can't wait to like really kick in.
Tell us a little bit about that.
I love Cuckoo. I worked with a girl named Bonnie McKee, and she co-wrote a lot of the stuff with the Katy Perry hits that were out. She did some stuff with Britney, Tyo Cruz. She's a really great pop writer. And we immediately clicked. She's an Aquarius like me. She's kind of eccentric. She's got a really good sense of what works in pop music and what's accessible and catchy, but she also has this kind of like quirky randomness about her. So we got a kick out of each other, and the producer we work with is this guy named Ali G, and he's an amazing like electro producer. He can do like a lot of that kind of like French, like Daft Punk or Justice or all that stuff of the Ed Banger records, like all those, that whole vibe. He's really into all that. He actually has his own thing called We Are Oliver. It's like his own electro DJ thing. And I kind of said to him, like, I want to do a dance song, but with like a funk groove, but I want to do it with like super electronic production. And I kept saying, like, let's do like Daft Punk. Let's like start kind of with that as the inspiration. Like, what would they do if they wanted to do a big pop vocal song? So that was the inspiration, and we started writing to it, and we actually did the verse right away. The verses and the pre-chorus were like super, we did on the fly, and it was very impulsive. The chorus we kept like working on, that's not working. And I don't know, that was like the third or fourth try that we had for a chorus, and it just felt right. It just felt so like sing-along. It kind of goes to like an 80s like hair metal kind of place almost. And that felt kind of silly, but that to me was supported by the song. It's basically saying like, I'm out of my damn mind, and I should be locked up. And so jumping to like hair metal all of a sudden feels like the total like illogical, nutty thing.
I remember when we were in the same direction. And all of a sudden we went,
blindsided by this chorus.
Yeah. It kind of comes out of you like, wow, yeah. I'm really, really proud of it. And what I really like is the bridge of the song, the part in the middle, it's, I gotta get out of this straitjacket, is the lyric. And obviously that goes with the whole like metaphor of being in an asylum and being crazy, but I put that lyric in there myself because I think there's like kind of a double meaning on that, a straitjacket. The industry and society in general sometimes doesn't just let you just be who the hell you want to be. And I've dealt with that a lot after American Idol. And it kind of says like, I need to break free, and I need to like not, I need to, you know, break out of any sort of bondage or control and do my own thing. And so the restraint of a straitjacket is basically saying, like, I want to be totally liberated.
That's a really cool one.
Yeah,
I like that a lot.
I can't wait to do the video. I have so many ideas.
Now, the last time, it kind of led me into one of my other questions, because last time I spoke to you, you gave me a really interesting quote that just resonated really well about being a role model for the gay community.
Mm-hmm.
And you said, I'm a singer, I'm not a babysitter, I'm not a politician.
That old chestnut.
I'm not here to try and show anybody how to do anything. Has those thoughts changed at all since the last
couple
years?
I think I was reluctant at first because that's a lot of responsibility for someone to tell you, like, oh, you're a role model for people. And you don't set out to be a role model. You know, like, my craft and my passion is music, and I'm creating music. But I think slowly over the last couple of years, I've grown more comfortable with the idea that, like it or not, I am. And that I should take responsibility for that and use the platform. And I've gotten really inspired by meeting people. Mm-hmm. Like at the time, I hadn't really met that, but you know, I just started.
Right.
So now I see like the effect that music can have on people and the community that's been built around. Like people coming to my concerts are friends, and they like do things together, and they keep in touch. And like the fact that it's created a community and like that safety net is really beautiful. And I've gotten letters and tweets and emails about people saying, you know, you've inspired me to be who I want to be, or to come out, or to be proud of how I'm different, or my looks, or whatever. And to be able to inspire people to do that is one of the more rewarding parts of this as a career, you know, as a gay.
You get irked when the moms on Twitter tell you how to behave.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm not somebody that really likes being told what to do by anybody, so.
Who gets that?
Yeah, I'm kind of a control freak, so I'm like, I'll do what I want to do. I mean, the album goes to that place a lot. Like,
that's it.
You know, like the song Trespassing, for example, is basically saying, you say keep out, you say I can't do this and I'm not welcome, well, I say fuck you, I'm going to do what I want, you know?
Fantastic.
That's what I love about that song, is it has so much attitude and it's like rebellious and it's like, fuck you. I'm fierce, you know? That's a really important one. I think that I wrote that specifically about the kind of the sadness that I feel sometimes when I look at the struggle of the gay and lesbian community, mm-hmm. and some of the things that we deal with as a community, like the equal rights stuff, the bullying, the, you know, the religious opposition. Like, there's issues that we have to deal with, and I think that we're progressing, and I think things are moving along, especially in America where it's a little bit, you know, there's some tension there. I think we're moving forward, but there's still a lot of like hurdles, and it makes me sad. And that's what the song's about. I think the cool thing about the song is that's what it means to me, but I know I played it for people and they're like, well, it sounds like Romeo and Juliet or mm-hmm. Bonnie and Clyde or, you know, Edward and Bella. You know, so there's kind of a, like most of the songs on the album, there's this very real explanation of what it is that I wrote about, but they're pretty universal.
Okay.
The album is really about like the human experience, and even though it's my personal take on it, I think that what I'm basically saying is, dark or light, we all have the same stuff that we deal with. And so why should we hate each other and feel so different when we're actually all pretty much boiled down to be the same human?
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Closer, closer. nights are getting colder.
Closing words.
I love EQ.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Thank you.
Slow it down. What do you want from me? What do you want from me?